by year, the boundaries of London march forward, pushing the countryside farther and farther away from the city's inner ring. Those who are wise get on a bus and leave behind once in a while their homes in the long, stony avenues of suburbia, or in the giant blocks of flats, or near grime of dockside and railside. Leave the city's smell and smoke and noise. Leave the teeming, jostling thoroughfares, some scarred and mutilated by war, or the streets of quiet suburbia. Leave the rush and racket of London to rest jaded minds and jangled nerves in the quiet health of England's countryside. Thanks to the preservation in perpetuity of a belt of open space around the city, Londoners have miles of parks and commons, woodlands and hillsides, farmland and fenland for recreation and for rest. Here, summer skies and open country call to the town dweller to come away for a holiday. Time to start homewards, to leave the peace and purity of the countryside and return to the wartime city, its darkened streets, its busy, throbbing life that slows down with nightfall, making way for the harsher, discordant sounds of war. The girdle of green round London is more precious today than ever it was before. These rare days in field or park or forest help to give the people strength to endure.